Oh, for a muse of fire that would ascend the brightest heaven of invention. A kingdom for a stage, princes to act, and monarchs to behold the swelling scene. Now let us, ciphers to this great accompt, on your imaginary forces work. For 'tis your thoughts that now must deck our kings. Carry them here and there, jumping o'er times, turning the accomplishment of many years into an hourglass. Now, gentle friends, admit me chorus to this history, who prologue-like your humble patience pray, gently to hear, kindly to judge our play.
Thank you. If the dull substance of my flesh were thought, injurious distance should not stop my way. For then, despite of space, I would be brought from limits far remote where thou dost stay. No matter then, although my foot did stand upon the farthest earth removed from thee, for nimble thought can jump both sea and land, as soon as think the place where he would be. But thought kills me, that I am not thought, to leap large lengths of miles when thou art gone, but that so much of earth and water rot, I must attend time's leisure with my moan, receiving not by elements so slow, but heavy tears, badges of either's woe.
It was a mother and his lass, and the very and the whole of Mary, that o'er the green cornfield, the green cornfield did pass in springtime. In springtime, before the liberty ringed on, when birds whose wings
but soft, what light through yonder window breaks? It is the east, and Juliet is the sun. Arise, fair sun, and kill the envious moon, who is already sick and pale with grief. It is my lady. Oh, it is my love. Oh, that she knew she were. She speaks, yet she says nothing. What of that? Her eye discourses. I shall answer it. I'm too bold. 'Tis not to me she speaks. Two of the fair stars in all the heaven, having some business, do entreat her eyes to twinkle in their spheres till they return. See how she leans her cheek upon her hand? Oh, that I may be a glove upon that hand, that I may touch that cheek.
I me.
She speaks. Speak again, bright angel.
Romeo. Romeo. Wherefore art thou Romeo? Deny thy father and refuse thy name. Or, if thou wilt not, be but sworn, my love, and I'll no longer be a Capulet.
Shall I hear more, or shall I speak at this?
'Tis but thy name that is my enemy. Thou art thyself, though not a Montague. What's Montague? It is nor hand, nor foot, nor arm, nor face, nor any other part belonging to a man. Be some other name. What's in a name? That which we call a rose by any other name would smell as sweet. So Romeo would, were he not Romeo called, retain that dear perfection which he owes without that title. Romeo, doff thy name, and for that name which is no part of thee, take all myself.
I take thee at thy word. Call me but love, and I'll be new baptized. Henceforth I'll never be Romeo.
What man art thou that thus bescreened in night so stumblest on my counsel?
By a name, I know not how to tell thee who I am. My name, dear saint, is hateful to myself because it is an enemy to thee. Had I it written, I would tear the word.
My ears have not yet drunk 100 words of that tongue's utterance, yet I know the sound. Art thou not Romeo and a Montague?
Neither, fair saint, if either thee dislike.
How camest thou hither, tell me, and wherefore? The orchard walls are high and hard to climb, and the place death, considering who thou art, if any of my kinsmen find thee here.
With love's light wings did I overperch these walls, for stony limits cannot hold love out, what love can dares love attempt, therefore thy kinsmen are no let to me.
Oh, if they do see thee, they will murder thee.
Alack, there lies more peril in thine eye than 20 of their swords. Look thou but sweet, and I am proof against their enmity.
Thou knowest the mask of night is on my face, else would a maiden blush bepaint my cheek. For that which thou hast heard me speak tonight, fain would I dwell on form, fain deny what I have spoke. But farewell compliment, dost thou love me? I know thou wilt say aye, and I will take thy word. Yet, if thou swearest, thou mayest prove false at lover's perjuries, then say, Jove laughs. Gentle Romeo, if thou dost love, pronounce it faithfully. Or if thou thinkest I am too quickly won, I'll frown and be perverse and say thee nay.
Lady, by yonder blessed moon, I swear, that tips with silver all these fruit tree tops.
Oh, swear not by the moon, the inconstant moon that monthly changes in her circled orb, lest that thy love prove likewise variable.
What should all I swear by?
Well, do not swear. Although I joy in thee, I have no joy of this contract tonight. It is too rash, too unadvised, too sudden, too like the lightning which doth cease to be ere one can say it lightens. Sweet, good night. This bud of love by summer's ripening breath may prove a beauteous flower when next we meet. Good night, good night. As sweet repose and rest come to thy heart as that within my breast.
Oh, will thou leave me so unsatisfied?
What satisfaction canst thou have tonight?
The exchange of thy love's fateful vow for mine.
I gave thee mine before thou didst request it. 3 words, dear Romeo, and good night indeed. If that thy bent of love be honorable, thy purpose marriage, send me word tomorrow by one that I'll procure to come to thee, where and what time thou wilt perform the rite, and all my fortunes at thy foot I'll lay and follow thee, my lord, throughout the world. But if thou mean'st not well, I do beseech thee to cease thy suit and leave me to my grief. Tomorrow will I send.
So thrive my soul.
1,000 times, good night.
10 times the worst to want thy light. Love goes towards love as schoolboys from their books, but love from love towards school with heavy looks.
Romeo?
My dear?
What o'clock tomorrow shall I send to thee?
At the hour of 9.
I will not fail. 'Tis 20 years till then. I have forgot why I did call thee back.
Let me stand here till thou remember it.
I shall forget to have thee still stand there, remembering how I love thy company.
And I'll still stay to have thee still forget, forgetting any other home but this.
'Tis almost morning. I would have thee gone, and yet no further than a wanton's bird, who lets it hop a little from her hand, like a poor prisoner in his twisted gyves, and with a silk thread plucks it back again, so loving jealous of his liberty.
Would I were thy bird.
Sweet, so would I, yet I should kill thee with much cherishing. Good night, good night. Parting is such sweet sorrow that I shall say good night till it be morrow.
When, in disgrace with fortune and men's eyes, I all alone beweep my outcast state, and trouble deaf heaven with my bootless cries, and look upon myself and curse my fate. Wishing me like to one more rich in hope, featured like him with friends possessed, desiring this man's art and that man's scope, with what I most enjoy contented least. Yet in these thoughts myself almost despising, happily I think on thee. And then my state, like to the lark at break of day arising from sullen earth, sings hymns at heaven's gate. For thy sweet love remembered such wealth brings, that then I scorn to change my state with kings.
Lady Beatrice, have you wept all this while?
Yea, and I will weep a while longer.
I will not desire that.
You have no reason. I do it freely.
Surely I do believe your fair cousin is wronged.
Ah, and how much might the man deserve me would right her?
Is there any way to show such friendship?
A very even way, but no such friend.
May a man do it?
It is a man's office, but not yours.
I do love nothing in the world so well as you. Is not that strange?
As strange as the things I know not. It were possible for me to say, I love nothing so well as you. But believe me not, and yet I lie not. I confess nothing nor I deny nothing. I am sorry for my cousin.
By my sword, Beatrice, thou lovest me.
Do not swear and eat it.
I will swear by it that you love me, and I will make him eat it that says I love not you.
Will you not eat your word?
If no sauce that can be devised to it. I protest, I love thee.
Well, why then, God forgive me.
What offense, sweet Beatrice?
You have stayed in a happy hour. I was about to protest, I love you.
And do it with all my heart.
I love you with so much in my heart that none is left to protest.
Come, bid me do anything for thee.
Kill Claudio.
Huh? Not for the wide world.
You kill me to deny it. Farewell.
Tarry, sweet Beatrice.
I am gone, though I am here. There's no love in you, nay, I pray you let me
Beatrice.
Go. And faith, I will go.
We'll be friends first.
You dare easier be friends with me than fight with my enemy.
Is Claudio thine enemy?
Is not a proven height a villain that has slandered, scorned, dishonored my kingswoman? Oh, if I were a man, what? Bear her in hand until they come to take hands? And then with public accusation, uncovered slander, unmitigated rancor. Oh, if I were a man, I would eat his heart in the marketplace.
Hear me, Beatrice.
Talk with a man out of a window with proper saying.
Nay, but Beatrice...
Sweet hero! She is wrong, she is slandered, she is undone.
Beatrice,
princes and counties, surely a princely testimony, a goodly count, count confetti, sweet gallant surely. Oh, if I were a man for his sake, or that I had any friends would be a man for my sake. The manhood is mounted into courtesies, valor into compliment, and men are only turned into tongue, and trim ones too. He is now as valiant as Hercules that only tells the lies and swears it. I cannot be a man with wishing, therefore I will die a woman with grieving.
Harry. Sweet Beatrice, by this hand I love thee.
Use it for my love some other way than by swearing by it.
Think you in your soul that Count Claudio hath wronged Hero?
Yea, as sure as I have a thought or a soul.
Enough. I am engaged. I will challenge him. On my life, Claudio shall render me a dear account. As you think of me, as you hear of me, so think of me. And so farewell.
Oh. Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? Thou art more lovely and more temperate. Rough winds do shake the darling buds of May, and summer's lease hath all too short a date. Sometime too hot the eye of heaven shines, and often is his gold complexion dimmed, and every fair from fair sometime declines, by chance or nature's changing course untrimmed. But thy eternal summer shall not fade, nor lose possession of that fair thou owest, nor shall death brag thou wanderest in his shade, when in eternal lines to time thou growest. So long as men can breathe or eyes can see, so long lives this, and this gives life to thee.
Oh, I warrant thee, if I do not act it, kiss me.
I will.
We'll use this unwholesome humidity, this gross, watery pumpkin. We'll teach him to learn turtles from Jake.
Am I dropping my heavenly jewel? Oh, now let me die. I have lived long enough. This is the period of my adventure. Now, I love thee.
Sweet Sir John.
This sword, I cannot break this sword. Now, I must sin in my wand. Would that your husband were dead. Yes, I would speak it to the best lord. I would make my lady.
Your lady, Sir John. Oh, I would make a pitiful lady.
Oh, who in the court of France could tell me that? I see how thy eye would emulate a diamond. Oh, thou hast the right, bright beauty of the brow, which brings us to become a mistress boy.
No, mistress boy. Mrs. Ford!
Oh, it's Mistress Page. At the door, sweating and blowing and looking wildly.
I would need speak with you presently.
She shall not see me. I will escort my sin.
Oh, do so. She's a very prowling woman.
Oh, Mistress Ford, what have you done?
Why, alas, what's the matter?
Oh, you're shamed. You're overthrown. You're undone forever.
What's the matter, Mistress Page?
Well, a day, Mistress Ford, having an honest man to your husband, to give him such cause of suspicion.
What cause of suspicion?
What cause of suspicion? Out upon you!
What is the matter?
Your husband's coming hither, woman, to search for a gentleman. He says is here now in the house by your consent.
Oh, no, it's just not so.
Oh, pray heaven it be not so. But 'tis most certain your husband's coming to search for such a man. I come before to tell you. If you know yourself in the clear, why, I am glad of it. But if you have a friend here, convey him out. Defend your reputation, or bid farewell to your good life forever.
Oh, no. What shall I do? There is a gentleman, my dear friend, but I care not so much for mine own shame as his peril.
For shame! Your husband's in hand! Convey him out! Oh, we have to find some way to get him out of this house! We cannot hide him here! Look! Here's a basket! If he be of any reasonable stature, he may creep in and we can throw foul linen upon him and as if it were going to laundry!
No, he's too big to go in there. What shall I do?
Let me see.
What?
I'm in. Oh.
Sir John Foster!
I love
you. Help me give away. Lord, you do.
I do so.
heaven make you better than your thoughts.
Amen!
You do yourself mighty wrong, Master Ford.
I may be the knave bragged of that which he could not compass.
Fie, Master Ford. Are you not ashamed? What devil, what spirit brought this imagination? I would not have your spirit towards me for all the wealth of Windsor Castle.
It is my fault. Mistress Ford, I suffer for it.
Thank you. feeding her flock near to the mountain side.
The shepherds
knew not whither she was gone.
Thank you.
Offend, it is with our goodwill that you should think we come not to offend, but with goodwill. To show our simple skill, that is the true beginning of our end. Consider then we come but in despite. We do not come as minding to contest you. Our true intent is all for your delight. We are not here that you should here repent you. The actors are at hand, and by their show you shall know all that you are like to know. Gentles, perchance you wonder at this show, but wonder on till truth make all things plain. This man is Pyramus, if you would know. This beauteous lady Thisbe is certain. This man with lime and ruff. This man with lime and ruff cast doth pres. This man with lime and rough cast doth present wall, that vile wall which did these lovers sunder. And through wall's chink, poor souls, they are content to whisper, at the which let no man wonder. This one, with lantern dog and bush of thorn, presenteth moonshine. For, if you would know, by moonshine did these lovers think no scorn to meet at Ninus' tomb, there to woo. This grisly beast, which lion hight by name, the trusty Thisbe coming first by night, did scare away, or rather did affright. And as she fled, her mantle she did fall, which lion vile with bloody mouth did stain. Anon comes Pyramus, sweet youth and tall, and finds his trusty Thisbe's mantle slain. Whereat, with bloody blameful blade, he bravely broached his boiling bloody breast. And Thisbe, tearing in mulberry shade, his dagger drew and died. For all the rest, let lion, moonshine, wall, and lovers twain at large discourse, for here they do remain.
Lovers Pyramus and Thisbe did whisper, often very secretly. This loam, this rough cast, this stone doth show that I am that same wall. The truth is so, and this the cranny is, right and sinister, through which the fearful lovers are to whisper.
Oh, grim-looked night, oh, night with hue so black, O night, whichever art when day is not. O night, alack, alack, alack. I fear my Thisbe's promise is forgot. And thou, O wall, O sweet, O lovely wall, show me thy chink to blink through with mine eyen. Thanks, courteous wall. Jove, she'll be well for this. But what's the eye? No Thisbe do I see. Oh, wicked wall, through whom I see no bliss, cursed be thy stones for thus deceiving me. Thisbe. Thisbe. Deceiving me is Thisbe's cue. She is to enter now, and I'm to spy her through the wall.
Thisbe!
You shall see it before I pant as I told you. Yonder she comes.
Oh, wall, full often hast thou heard my moans for parting my fair Pyramus and me. My cheery lips have often kissed thy stone with lime and hair knit up in thee.
I see a voice. Now will I to the wall to spy, and I can hear my Thisbe's face. Thisbe?
My love, I think.
Think what thou wilt. I am thy lover's grace, and like Lymander, am I trusty still.
And I, like Helen, to the fates me kill.
Not Schaeffelus to Procris was so true.
As Schaeffelus to Procris, I to you.
Oh, kiss me through the hole of this vile wall.
I kiss the wall's hole, not your lips at all.
Wilt thou at Nini's tomb meet me straightway?
To life, till death, I come without delay.
Thus have I, wall, my part discharged so, and being done, doth wall away, doth go.
You, ladies, you, whose gentle hearts do fear, the smallest monstrous mouse that creeps on floor may now perchance both quake and tremble here, when lion rough in the wildest range doth roar. Then know that I, in fact a man, ain't a lion fell, nor else no lion's dame. For if I should as a lion come in strife into this place, 'twere a pity on my life.
Sweet moon, I thank thee for thy sunny beams. I thank thee, moon, for shining now so bright. For by thy gracious golden glittering gleams, I trust to take of truest Thisbe sight. But stay, O spite, but mark, poor knight, what dreadful dole is here. Eyes, do you see? How can it be? Oh, dainty duck. Oh, dear. Thy mantle good, what stained with blood. Approach, ye furies fell. Oh, fates, come, come. Cut thread and thrum. Quail, crush. Conclude and quell.
Oh, wherefore, nature, didst thou lion's frame, since lion vile hath here deflowered my dear, which is, which was the fairest dame? Come, tears confound, outsword, and wound the pap of Pyramus, I that left pap where heart doth hop. Thus die I. Lass. Now am I fled. Now am I dead. My soul is in the sky. Tongue, loose thy light. Moon, take thy flight. Now die. Die.
So are her thoughts that vanquish thee there.